Hi, I'm Mike.
I'm Don.
And this is the International Space Station
Science Garage.
What do we got today?
Balloons.
We have a balloon.
Yep.
And a knit needle.
But the balloon has got, it's got a pretty interesting tail on them.
It does.
But, okay, it's very colorful.
But what we have today is this saying, which anybody can make if you want. It's called an electroscope.
You made this out of an ice cream thing.
Here we got, yeah.
Sicilian, did you do this for me? Sicilian pistache, because I come from a Sicilian background.
No, actually I did it because it happens to be a perfect shaped jar to make an electroscope.
Who would have thought? It's kind of fattening this stuff too.
Yeah, but it makes a great electroscope.
Okay.
There's two pieces of aluminum foil there.
Okay.
And they're hanging on this little wire. And you charge a balloon up with your hair.
With your head, all right.
Okay, and then you go like that and see, look how.
Wow, so that stuff moved.
Yeah, okay.
So it transferred the static electricity. That's amazing.
Yeah, and so the.
Yeah, go ahead.
So the charge repels each other. You have a like charge on each one of those leaves,
right.
And so they push each other away. Now go ahead and touch the electrode.
Let's see what happens to the leaves.
Oof. Okay, so you removed the charge.
And it came into me.
It came into you.
I felt
okay.
Shocked.
Now, so I'm charge this up again. See, look at that. And now here's a knitting needle. If I bring the knitting needle up, what does it do? Okay, nothing there. Let's rub it on the balloon and now see what happens. Nothing again. It wasn't supposed to do that.
Why don't we try it again? Try it again.
Okay.
So what you're trying is you're hoping that it's an opposite charge. So
yeah,
try.
Yeah. Okay, but
maybe it went in the other direction. Oh, look at that. Let's rig it. No, let's move it a little bit.
No.
Why did you have to put this in? If you just had this, if you just suspended this.
Okay, let's just.
The only reason to have this in a jar is just so it's suspended, right?
Yeah, and that see, yeah, it's not messed up by other things. Like a small amount of breeze would mess these things up.
I see. So this is. How'd you figure this experiment out?
Just this is.
Head?
You know, any
you
kid. No, any kid that's 8 years old. No, any kid. I mean, this is a classic thing that kids do for science projects where you make an electroscope.
Okay.
And then you use it for investigating other forms, you know, little static charge thing.
You think I got any charge in my head? Can I try it on my hair?
Sure, and you know, maybe it's opposite charge.
Let's do it as a trying to get a lot of charge.
Whoa.
Look at that. Uh-huh. And, that's pretty big.
And now let's see what happens. Wow. Okay. Now, this electroscope has a gravitational component. You need gravity to kind of pull down on those leaves. Mm-hmm. So the charge force is now balanced against gravitational force. So an electroscope like this would not work in a weightless environment
space.
Well, the leaves would just go whack.
Well, they would. Okay. So it wouldn't work.
I mean, they wouldn't come back together again. So you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between when it was charged and when it wasn't charged.
Oh, because it was just floating.
Yeah, because the leaves would just float. So how could you make an electroscope that would work in a weightless environment? Could you make a simple thing? I mean, this is a Benjamin Franklin.
Impossible. Type. No, it's not impossible. How can you do it?
Well, I made one on Expedition 30.
Why am I not surprised to hear that?
And I wasn't able to make it until Joe Acaba came up.
Because you needed his head to make the electrical charge.
No. Why? He brought along a necklace, a silver necklace from either his sister or his mother or something like that. He had the silver necklace that he'd flown to station for them.
That's very nice.
Yeah, really nice. A fine silver little chain.
Yeah.
And so I took the chain. And I had
Give it back, Don?
I only borrowed it for a day.
All right, okay.
So I had two strands of chain suspended between a plastic cylinder with a little wire like that.
Uh-huh.
And the chain would just kind of just sit there and float, the two strands of chain.
Yeah.
And then when you take a balloon and you'd rub it on your head and you would charge, the two pieces of chain would just pop out like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you took the charge away, then the pieces of chain would just kind of just float around again.
Wow. All right, so.
We were able to take just the silver chain and make it into a zero gravity equivalent of an electroscope.
I'm sorry, but what would the thing about the chain that allowed you to do that, it was because it was more material, or?
It was anchored on both ends, and it has very little friction in terms of holding its shape. If you took tin foil like this and you anchored it on both ends, it would be too stiff, and the charges wouldn't bend it out.
I see. So you needed something that could take the charge.
It had to conduct the charge. Right. You needed two elements so that they would both have the same charge and they'd repel each other.
Right.
But it had to have very little friction.
Right.
So here you have very little friction, but you're balancing charge force with gravitational force. Mm-hmm. You don't have the gravitational force, so the charge forces would try mm-hmm. to push the links of the chain away, but they're bound on each mm-hmm. end, and they just kind of bow out like that.
And if you just had a piece of wire...
Too stiff.
It was too stiff. If you had a piece of the tin foil...
Too stiff.
Too stiff.
And if it was only anchored on both ends, it would be too stiff. Mm-hmm. But if it was only anchored on one end, then it would just be flying around.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between when it was charged and when it wasn't charged.
Right. So the chain.
The chain.
Was just right.
It was just
like,
right.
It's like the Goldilocks thing. I think the point I'm trying to make, somehow, believe it or not, is that you have to find the right material. You have to find
what's
just right to show the phenomenon can still be at work. But you can't observe it without the right,
that's right.
combination of things.
And it took a while. I wanted to make an electroscope, and I tried mm-hmm. it with aluminum foil 27 different ways, and I couldn't get it to work.
Mm-hmm.
And I tried it with
so you were trying.
I was trying, and I just couldn't get it to work.
You don't give up easy.